Hey, it's Joseph here. I don't really have an outline for this video. We're just gonna see how it goes. I have plans to unbox a bunch of boxes, but I think it's gonna be in multiple videos. So don't get surprised if you see me on this shirt in multiple videos. But here is the first box that I wanna open. So I have received this product from Sabrent for review purposes, USB 3.0 10 port hub with power switches. There's a specific reason why I requested to review this specific product, and I'll get into that a bit, but just to kind of read off its packaging, features 10 super speed USB 3.0 ports and blue LED to indicate power. The most useful feature of this device is the fact that it has switches, meaning that you can actually turn on and off. And I have a very similar device already that I am using, so I'll show you in a bit how I am using it so far and how this is going to be an upgrade for it. Let's just go ahead and unbox it first. So inside, it is wrapped around like this. And then there is a main part. I wonder if there are some cables and manuals and such. So there's another box inside of the box, and then some paperwork that say, Sabrent, you're covered, extend your warranty, some manual, probably don't need all of that. Let me undo this one. That is actually looking quite good. So you can turn each USB on and off and open this smaller box. There's quite a lot of cables than I have expected. So first is USB A to USB B 3.0, so that this is going from here on one end of the device to the PC. Let's actually undo the cable tie so we can connect that. And then goes on to the back end of this device, and the other end will go to my PC. And then here is the power portion, the first end of the brick. And then here is the brick. So you just connect one end, obviously. And this is 60 watt, and it's got one barrel plug. And because you're gonna be connecting a lot of devices to this USB hub, it is good to have this power so that your computer is not powering everything. It's gonna put some strain on your device itself, meaning if it is a laptop, then you don't wanna draw more power from the laptop precious battery. And also if it is a desktop, you also don't want to introduce more power draw to your power supply. Although it can supply good amount of power when it becomes a lot of ports, 10 ports, 10 different devices, it can kind of stack up. So it is good to have a separate source of power for the sake of the safety, making sure that every device connected has enough amount of power. This end connects to one corner of the device. So yeah, it is quite a lot of cable dangling, but I'm sure we'll get through this. Okay, so now we are just left with the stuff that was inside of the box. And before I forget, let's check out the price for this device. At the time of shooting of this video, which is February 13 on Amazon, it is going for $47.99 for this specific model. There are a few different variants, but 10 USB 3.0 port is what you're looking for. So this is about $50 gadget that you can have, but I find it quite useful. So perhaps you can watch this video to find out why I'm using this device. Okay, so with the price out of the way, let me show you what I currently have in terms of the setup. And in order to do that, I'm gonna have to use my phone for this video. So actually, there you are. I'm shooting myself there and you can see myself here. And if you look over here, product here, which has four different switches. So this specific red one here, which is connected to the camera, goes back and then loops back into my desktop that is mounted underneath this desk. Therefore, I am able to see what is going on the camera on sort of bigger screen. And then when it comes to this button right here, it is powering. So it's just power alone that is going back to the camera. And if I undo this switch, basically my camera turns off. So let me go ahead and pause recording on here. So I'm doing that on my computer. So I've paused my video there. And then if I just press that button, notice how The camera turns off since there's no power to it. So when I'm ready to shoot, what I do is I just press that and then camera turns on. I hope that kind of makes sense. And I got this line here that's connected to a bunch of other peripherals of the PC. And then this line here is actually looping back out. So basically, if I need to connect some sort of USB-C devices for charging or connecting to the computer, I can use this cable. So for example, I can use this external drive from Rev Power, and one end is USB-C. Therefore, I can just connect onto here and then my computer is going to recognize. So that is sort of how I'm using it. And if I just need to turn it off, I can just do that and turn it off. And I find this sort of switch is really useful because I can keep certain type of peripherals turned off. But right now, this is going out to another hub that's on the other side of the desk. So if I turn that off, it's going to turn everything off on the desk. So it will definitely be useful to have a lot more switches and ports available for me to turn on and off individually. So let me go back to turning the camera back on. And then I'm going to attempt to replace that device with this one. And one thing I did notice is the fact that right now my configuration has a switch on the front, and from the back there are cables connected. Therefore, it's kind of hard to reach all the way back there and connect and disconnect a specific cable if I need to swap out a cable. But because this one is top loading, it's gonna be a lot easier to see and then connect, disconnect specific type of ports and then switch them on and off as I need them to. So let me go ahead and do that myself and then I'll report back. And during that process, the camera will definitely shut off. So let me just pause that video. So I now have everything connected back. Now I got a whole bunch that is left over. I can connect more, but let me go ahead and turn on all of these. This specific one is going to the peripherals that are connected to this monitor here, but there actually is none that is connected, so it is not ringing up anything. And this one, if I turn it on, then this wire becomes live. And then if I turn this on, the camera gets connected and the data flows to my desktop. However, it is not on, it is not powered on. Therefore, it is not sending any data at the moment. However, if I go ahead and turn this one on, it will be powered on, and then now the data starts to flow back into my desktop. And therefore, it is now connected. And I just need to click on live shoot and then start recording. So now we are back to my main camera. And I wanted to show you what I took out. So basically, it's this specific one, and then it is USB 3.0. Therefore, it is still high speed and maintains high speed through these ports here. And because I like this so much, I have another one. But both of them are going to be out of commission since I got much better one. Thank you, Sabrent, for sending me the product. I'm really going to enjoy your product again. And also, I now have a leftover of extension cable. This is USB 3.0 extension cable. The cable wasn't long enough to reach all the way back to the desktop that is mounted underneath. Therefore, I had to use this cable. However, this specific one has much longer cable that I can route back to the desktop. So there is definitely that plus that you don't have to pay for something like this. And this specific product happens to be Sabrent product as well, but this is USB 3.0 SD card reader. It can read full size SD card as well as micro SD card. And it is really useful to take out the SD card off of my camera and connect here if I'm doing different shoots around the studio. Then I can transfer all the videos onto a computer a lot quicker than I would transfer through camera USB cable, because that's much slower transfer rate. This is what I like to use. Only the downside is the fact that this device kind of goes into sleep mode. I don't know why exactly, but because this kind of is like a hub of some sort, when I am not reading any data off of the SD card, it kind of goes onto that sleep mode. The computer makes that USB disconnected sound. Therefore, it is kind kind of annoying. So what I would like to do is permanently leave this on the hub and then just turn the switch on and off whenever I need them and when I don't need them. So that is definitely going to be useful. And one more thing that I want to mention on this video is this gum-like blue thing. This is something I learned in UK and which wasn't so present in United States. I think it's sort of the cultural thing. They call it blue tag, made by a company called Bostik. And I ordered this off of Amazon, but apparently it is manufactured in UK, so somehow I reached back. I have a little bit of past with living in London for a bit, and that's why I kind of picked this one up. And for people who's not aware of this product, may find it useful. So it is basically like a dough, but it is sticky. I've heard some people refer this as sticky tape, and I don't know why they call it a tape, because it's sort of a dough. But what it is really useful is it's got all different weird things that you can do with it, including just kind of fidgety toy. But you can just take some out, and then what you do is you just put it underneath the things that you want to stick onto, right? The obvious reasons to use this. And then once you mount onto the desk like that, then it's really solid. You can take device on and off, and it's gonna stick there. It's not gonna move around. And that's what I've done with this one here, as well as the little power brick, the power supply. I stuck that underneath the desk with this, I don't know, blue tack or sticky tape, however you call it, underneath the desk so that it doesn't fall. And you can always take it off and there's no residue left. People do put this on the wall because you don't wanna ruin the wall. However, I have noticed that on my wall, if I were to use this product, it kind of leaves that sort of oily residue on the paint. So be aware when you're using it on a wall. And because this is sticky, there are numerous times that I have nicked my wall. The whole paint or a drywall piece has fallen off with this piece. So I wouldn't really advise it to use it on a painted wall. However, it is perfectly fine to use on like a door or type of trim work or a desk like this, and it is going to be useful. So I just kind of wanted to mention that. And by the way, I'm going to leave all the product links in the description for you guys to find out where to buy them if you're interested. So if you found this video useful, please like and subscribe to my channel to continue watching these type of videos. I hope that was a little bit off topic but useful. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I'll see you next time.